Next up, we have the Sustainable Small Business of the Year. This category honors the small business that is mindful of its impact on the environment, especially in areas of solid waste, energy conservation, water conservation, and wastewater pollution prevention. The winner shows outstanding effort or leadership to foster sustainability in their organization or the community. And the nominees are Cascade Baking Company. Cascade Baking uses a radiant heat brick oven which uses half the energy of traditional ovens, and they've upgraded their lighting and cooling systems. They reuse and recycle everything they can. They purchase ingredients from local farmers and producers, and they replaced bottled water with a water dispenser. And next we have DIY Studio. In addition to what we learned earlier about diverting reuse materials, they're also an all-volunteer nonprofit. Through their store and classes, they put junk in a new light for the community. It's seen as a resource instead of worthless. And participants learn to become contributing members of the community through their creativity and environmental action. Then we have Fresh and Local Foods. Fresh and Local Foods provides local, fresh, organic meals to schools and other institutions. They include community and the environmental impacts in all their decision making. They've invested $250,000 in solar, electric, and hot water systems, and they've installed stations to sanitize with heated water instead of harsh chemicals. And then we have Minto Island Growers, an organic farm. The farm provides uncropped natural habitat for wildlife and native bees. They also reuse and recycle almost all materials on the farm, and I think that's a theme we're going to hear a little bit. And that's not an easy thing to do, including nursery trays, totes, and crates. They use biodegradable organic earth pots in place of six-pack plastic containers for plant starts, and they've installed new irrigation pumps that save energy and water. Then we have O'Neill Pine Company. O'Neill Pine Company building, their building is energy and water efficient as well as being friendly for reuse and recycling. They expect tenants of their building to adhere to eco-friendly practices. Their timberlands are forest stewardship certified, stewardship council certified. And their employees and tenants who do not drive to work are compensated the value of a monthly bus pass. Good deal. Then we have Salem Ale Works. Salem Ale Works donates spent grain to local farmers for livestock feed and compost. They also reuse their process water to clean the brewery. They store beer in large kegs and sell beer in refillable growlers to eliminate waste. And they source their ingredients locally. And our final nominee is Santiam Valley Ranch. Santiam Valley Ranch is a 150-acre farm rearing fish, wildlife, waterfowl, and sheep, and they also lease some of their land for cultivation of sweet corn and beans. They reuse and recycle everything they can. They've installed wind and solar energy systems, and a large part of their farm is used for wetland prairie restoration. And the winner is Santiam Valley Ranch. Come on up.
Blue skies smiling at me. Nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue birds singing a song. Nothing but blue birds all day long.
Right.
Never saw the sun shining bright. Never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurry by. When you're in love, my, how they fly. Blue days, all of them gone. Nothing but blue skies from now on.
We ready for Santiam's slide? There we go. So we'll start with the energy efforts that they've put in. You can see here they have a 5 kilowatt home photovoltaic system through Solar City on the farm home, and a 20.4 system on the barn, and a 20 kilowatt wind turbine. So they've seen nearly $3,000 in savings in 2013 from just the two farm systems, the wind turbine and the 20.4 system. And then next slide. 95% of the water used in their indoor holding tanks for rearing the fish is recycled through the system, saving the water using biofilters, an ozone system that I believe, Ken, you developed yourself, and a UV radiation. And then the final wastewater flows through a series of ponds for a final natural treatment where the larger fish are raised after they've been started in the smaller tanks. And I think the holding tanks are also used when you have buyers ready to buy fish too. See, I studied. I did my homework. they also, and this was an incredible effort here. They joined with adjacent landowners to create one of the largest private wetland restoration projects in Oregon. So there's over 400 contiguous acres in the Mill Creek floodplain now set aside, and 99 of their own 150 acres are included in that project. And 8 acres have been converted to wetland woodlands. So we've got some great wetland forest and trees in there also. And then everything that can be, as I said, a common theme is reused, repaired, or recycled in true farm tradition. They do not have garbage service, have not had it for many years, I think over 30. And they take about 3 to 4 trips a year to the transfer station and drop off a lot of their stuff here at the recycling station. And both Kathy and Ken are Marion County Master Recyclers. Congratulations. Well earned.
Blue sky smiling at me. Nothing but blue skies do I see.